Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Enderal Forgotten Stories Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. What am I doing here in my own house? It has fake books and stuff like that. I'm in the Mage Mansion. One of the houses you can buy. You can name it yourself, too. But I'm back here at the Phasmalus workbench. I couldn't resist trying to find him some more items out in the Sun Temple. All I managed to find was some more spell books. So, I think if you give him the spell books, he ends up using them. So, Firebolt, he had rank. What's this, 4? I thought I picked up 6. Is 5. I thought I picked up 6. That's not as good then. So never mind that one. Is that him? He's come to observe. The famous Lorem Waterblade. Alright, so we're gonna skip that one, but I'm gonna give him options as far as Chain Lightning. I think you can do this all in one, but I'm just gonna. Wow, quite a bit. I think it's just to do that. Alright, got a bit of items. Equip. Just in case I start running out of one of the things. So we're not doing that. Flash heal, I figure it would be good. Let's do ice breath first. Ectoplasm bone meal. Soul gems. There's a lot more items for the other tome. Unfortunately, I have to keep going through this. Flash heal, I figure it would be good for him. He might use that if he gets low on health. Three bone meal, soul gems. Why do you have to use a greater soul gem? I guess if I put some other soul gems away, it could use, but I have enough. Like, if I put some soul gems in a chest or something like that, it'll use the petty one. Because. Well, that's all I have now is Grand and Greater. It used my other ones up. Alright. That's for a good cause. And then. We have one or two more. Divine Shield. He might use that. He might remember to use that. 79 bone meal? Good God. Wait, is it gone? Wait a second. It should be still in my inventory then. I hope. Divine Shield. Yeah, it's here, okay. So I don't need the Firebolt rank 4. So now if we look at what he has. You have to go to remove just to see the listing. He's got Chain Lightning rank 4. He already had Firebolt rank 5. He has Flash Heal rank 5. Ice Breath rank 6. And Life Absorption rank 5. Awesome. I need bone meal. Like, a lot of bone meal. And I've been picking up bone meal left and right. I need to have, like, a, I think it was a total of 79 bone meal or something. That's crazy. I wonder if they're selling a lot of bone meal. And the soul gems need to be filled, I'm sure. I can just quickly run. Hi. Just like, you can't reach me.
Here. There, lady. Certainly. Just take your time.
Ingredients. You do not have bone meal.
Certainly.
Do you have...
Just take your time.
Filled soul gems. No.
Take care.
I need a lot of soul gems, too. And I've been buying those up everywhere, too. Probably why he doesn't have any.
You helped defend the city, didn't you? Thank you. But why didn't anyone listen to me in the first place? I told them those Naramis were dangerous. And now this happens.
Happen to have any tips?
Well, maybe I do. But why don't you ask one of your thousand husbands, full woman?
First, you tell me thank you.
You helped defend the city, didn't you?
Oh my, now who is this?
Now you like me again.
I've seen this face, so yes, hooray! What can I do for you?
Too much chatter.
I promise you, they'll bring you me.
I'll take all that. Bone meal you do not have. I can't think of a rhyme for that. At least I found a few soul gems.
I'm opulent.
What? Oh, yes, certainly.
Not selling soul gems. Oh, that reminds me too. You're not selling bone. Oh, you're selling three. It barely helps, but okay. I bought a lot more master books and sneaking. While I was looking for stuff for him. Not sneaking. I keep saying that. Lockpicking. This uses up all my crafting points at the moment. So now... We have one crafting point left. Just need to find another book. But our lockpicking is 93. So if I find 7 more of those books... That'd be a good thing. And over here I think is fit size puzzle box. See if he has soul gems and bone meal.
Walk blessed. Of course. Take your time.
Okay. I will. Okay, nothing there. No ingredients. Alright.
Good luck and safe. Walk blessed, my dad.
Get back in your shop. How are you doing? Alright, back to the Sun Temple for now. I don't know when I'm going to find that much bone meal. I gotta collect a lot of bone meal. But, it's this way? They might be selling some down
a
here.
A machine that can banish these high ones. The mysteries of this world are endless, aren't they?
Just checking to see if they have... She probably doesn't have that kind of thing.
Sure. You'll have to pay normally, though. As much as the Grandmaster favors you, metal and work don't come for free.
Duneville Steel Sword? I didn't know they had specific for Duneville. She doesn't have anything we're looking for.
Walk blessed.
No, no. I hit that. Didn't mean to hit that. At least it's a quick loading time. That one I wanted. She's busy. Hi.
Well, then you've come to the right place.
I think we need filled ones, but just in case. One bone meal. Oh my god.
Get
out of my sight. Back to the main quest. We'll see. Hopefully find some bone meal along the way. Then you can use Divine Shield. They only had rank 3. I'm using 4. 5? Which one am I using? 6. So, maybe by then we'll have find a new... Oh yeah, we need to go sleep in here. We'll find a new Divine Shield spell that needs to... Even more stuff.
Huh. You're the one they call the Prophet, aren't you?
Well, at least it's noon now. We're going to sleep at noon.
Congratulations on passing the trial.
She left off the "you guessed" part and bumped me with her boobs. This way. We have to sleep in this specific bed? Okay. Back to the main quest, finally. Oh, what? Here we go again. I have to talk with Daddy. He has something important to tell me. Oh, standing on this thing. I don't want to talk to Daddy. Daddy's scary. I have my stuff this time, though. I can't switch views, though, so... And I do look smaller. Is everything the same around here? Horses? Nutritiousness of meat, but we can't pick it up. Like, the first time we were able to pick it up. I do not like this place. I do not like Daddy. He's a scary man. Oops. Feels like I'm getting smaller and smaller, actually. I remember this over here. Used to be able to read that letter, now we can. It's getting less interactive. The Matrix is, glitching out here. Some pretty bloody wood there.
Now look who's here. So, my child?
You look burned.
I know you still didn't find it. You think you know what you're doing. But the truth is, you're still wandering through the mist, just like all the others.
The mist? You're wrong, Daddy. We found the torch, and I found the fire. He said we were looking for something at the beginning of the game. Did you find it? He wanted me to find a torch all this time?
Yes. That is what you believe. You know, it would be so easy to see the truth, to feel it. If you, for all your heroism, had not forgotten one thing. To listen.
Trying.
Let me show you what I mean.
I don't want to see what you mean. Last time you showed me something, it was very unpleasant. Used to be able to pick up these things. The meat.
Well, there we go. Sit down and let us listen to the silence.
The silence?
Okay, fine. I get it. You know you have sinned, and that's why you're lying. But look, honey, I'm your husband, and I deserve the truth.
Another daddy.
Lying is a sin. You know that as well as I do. And you also know the position this puts me in.
What else do you want me to say? It's ours. Yours.
Mine? You make me unhappy. You know that. You make me very, very unhappy.
You're an abusive little guy, aren't you? Oof. The sound, stifled sound of a kick can be heard, shattering glass.
Whose child is it?
Oh. I'm not... Is that me, the child? Mother whimpers and cries. I also have a sister.
Oh, Lord. Is this what I get for my piety? All these years I sacrificed myself for this family. I toiled. I buried my dreams. And all of it because I wanted them to be happy. And now... Now my own witch betrays me and carries another one's fruit in her belly.
That be me?
But no. No. As if that weren't enough, she denies me the truth.
You're not my daddy.
Her own husband. Just what am I supposed to do now, Lord? I beg you, tell me. What shall I do?
Burn the place down. And everyone in it, apparently. Or did I do that?
Of course, Lord. You are right. How could I be so blind? The Creator has spoken to me, honey. A child born of sin is tainted. And this is why we will drown it.
Yes,
that's what we'll do. As soon as it's out, we'll put it in the trough.
As soon as it's out? You can say it like that. You're drown the kid.
You're a goddamned monster.
You're a monster.
I beg your pardon.
No,
I think you just said something that
that's a life.
Really unhappy. But unfortunately, I didn't hear you loudly enough. So please... Be so kind as to say it again.
Let me say it. Ooh.
What? I can't hear you, darling.
You're a monster.
I can't hear you.
Oh my god. Evil man.
So tell me, my child. How does it feel to be powerless? How does it feel having to watch and not being able to do anything?
I couldn't help. I never could.
No. But now you can, can't you?
Can I?
But there's no more time, silly. I have to go now, forever. It's been so long since I last ate. And I'm craving a slice of meat. Bloody, crisp meat.
What's it with you and meat?
Goodbye.
What? Can I get up?
Hey, Saira, wake up. What's the matter?
What a dream. Save them. We need to save them. And light the beacon.
What? But we will. You found the black stones, Saira, and we'll use them to banish the High Ones, no matter how hard this Quarak tries to stop us. But first of all, calm down a little.
I had a bad dream. I'm fine, though. What happened? Why are you here? I mean, not that I mind.
Well, because I heard you screaming, I suppose?
Oh, was I?
And both Sharim and the Archmagister were asking for you. Apparently they have a clue as to where to find this Numenos.
The Numenos.
You should go see them as soon as possible.
Right. Fair enough, then. Where are they? At the beacon?
No, they're in the Chronicum. One more thing before you go, though. There's something I need to ask you. The mercenary. Sorry for asking, but how do you feel about him?
Oh! What's his name? Forgotten Homeland, Part 1. Jespar. Speak with Lexel Mariel and Yuslan Sharim in the Chronicum. I'm talking about, Jespar. We're friends. Why do you ask?
I was just curious.
Oh, and you appreciate
that. Thanks for being honest with me. Anyway, we'll talk again later. Take it slow. You don't look too well.
Had a rough night, or afternoon, or something.
Yes.
What do you think about current events?
Until that Quarik appeared, I actually thought things were going relatively well, like with the Sigil Stone and this beacon. But a war with Nareem, that changes everything. They trump us in every aspect. Manpower, equipment, siege machinery. Let's just hope the walls of Ark are really as durable as they're said to be.
Yeah. At least some of this stuff I've asked before. These two I have. Why is it that you always say Karash? Isn't that Kyranian?
Yes, it is. Master Tyrus, my foster father. He was half Kyranian, as you might have guessed already. Some words just stuck around.
Okay. Alright, I guess I'm off to talk to them. Apparently the Arcanist found a clue leading to the Numenos. That peculiar object that is missing for igniting the beacon. I have to meet them in the Chronicum. Alright. It's like we're going the same path. I can't match people's walking. Either gonna move faster or slower than they do. If you search in. Are you going there too?
You. I heard you passed the trial without going to the novitiate.
They're going through
there. Congratulations, I guess. The Grand Master must think highly of you.
Thanks, I guess. So, she's asking me about Jespar, huh?
Sounds to me as if we'd risk a lot for just a ghost of a chance. I'm not sure if this is wise.
No chance is better than two. That's how the saying goes. You should talk to the Grandmaster. He called for you.
Did he now? How nice.
No chance.
Then I suppose I'll answer the holy call of duty. Walk blessed, Archmagister. Ah, Prophetess. If you have a moment, I'd like to talk. Just come upstairs when you find the time.
Okay.
There you are. Have you recovered?
He grabbed me first. How is no chance better than two? Or no choice better than two? So good as it gets, I suppose. How's the situation?
Well, I suppose as good as can be expected under our circumstances. The Truchessis sent half our Arcanists to reinforce the Gate Sigil, which makes working on the beacon harder, of course.
Hmm.
Furthermore, the nightmares have become worse, and more reports of the Red Madness are coming in. It's tragic. Yeah. Truly tragic.
My nightmares have gotten worse. More cases of Red Madness, huh?
Yes. Citizens are disappearing from the city, and our outposts are finding them in the wilderness, starving and delirious. And even worse, they are extremely violent. Take care if you're on the road.
Yeah. Same as always, everything attacks you. Do you think the High Ones are gaining power?
Oh yes, without any doubt. The war has made things far worse. It's almost as if the High Ones draw strength from the chaos. Or
probably.
Maybe it's a sign that the cleansing is approaching. I don't know.
Yeah, we don't have enough info, right? So what's the progress with the beacon? I've been told you found a lead regarding the Numinos.
Well, let's say we have a lead to a place where we could find a lead. But let me start at the beginning.
Okay.
While you were sleeping, someone tried to break into the storehouse of the garrison. A starling named Kermai.
Oh, I know him. Kermai. I've heard that name. I think I did him a favor some time ago. Actually, it wasn't that long ago. Relatively speaking, if I remember correctly, he's the one I got all those eggs from. I get eggs for, really. Yeah, I think I did him a favor regarding eggs.
You have? That's good. Then he might trust you.
Maybe. Do we trust him, though? Why did he break into the storeroom?
Well, brace yourself. He said he was looking for shadow steel, because he's been working on a starship for 2 decades now. He wants to use it to find the forgotten homeland of his people.
Huh. Figure you could buy it? Instead of breaking into places. His forgotten homeland.
Yes. Doesn't it ring a bell?
Yes.
The Star People believe that their ancestors were born in a forgotten place among the stars. A place without war or hunger, where everyone lives in perfect harmony.
Maybe.
All the technology, all the machines that we owe to them, were invented to help them get back to this place. A very nostalgic idea, it really is, but unfortunately, a lot of Star People have died in that quest. The starships have crashed, or they simply disappeared. Up until now, no one has ever found the Star City. Kermai, however, claims that he can do it.
They've been trying to do that for forever. Whether it's a place of no war and no strife or anything like that, you never know. It's been so long. Did they even have that recorded, you know? Or was it just passed down and embellished over the decades? Millennia, however long. It's been quite a while. It's been hundreds of years, at least. So, how does that involve the Numinos?
Well, bear with me. At first, of course, we all considered him insane. He was begging and pleading and insisting that he was just an inch from finishing his ship, and that it really could get him to the Star City. Unlike the others, the Grandmaster listened to him, and he ordered the scouts in Duneville to look for the cave where he claimed his workshop was. And you won't believe it, but they found out 2 things. First of all, the ship really does exist. And secondly, he says he used ancient starling plans to construct the ship, which were handed down for generations in Anku, the starling city on Merin.
Anku?
We had a look at them. They look very similar to the plans we used to construct the beacon.
Similar. So you're implying that the ancient fathers of the starlings, who apparently live in this forgotten city, are also the ones who created the beacon? I thought the beacon was created by the Pyreans.
Well, either that, or the ones who created the beacon also helped the Ancient Fathers build the Star City. There's no way to know for sure.
Huh.
But either way, what it does mean is that the Ancient Fathers must have known about the cycle, and therefore about the High Ones and the cleansing.
And you think they could help us find out what the Numinos is?
Well, let's put it this way. If anybody knows, it's them. And it's definitely the best lead we have found so far. So, in other words, what that means is that we need to help this Kermai finish his ship, and that we will accompany him on his journey to the Star City.
Oh.
Just imagine if it works. A city in the stars that has lasted for millennia. It's unbelievable. Truly unbelievable.
Can they really go back there? Yeah, that's a good question. So it's our goal to get the ship flying, to travel to the Star City, that would be amazing, and find the Numinos with the help of its citizens.
You make it sound so easy. But, in a nutshell, yes, that's what we need to do.
I never said it was easy, but there's a few steps involved, and those are the steps. So how do we proceed, then?
First, You should visit Kamai's workshop in the Powder Desert. The Grand Master and some Arcanists have already left.
Oh, I don't want to go back to Powder Desert.
Needless to say, be vigilant when outside the city. The Neremese might not be careless enough to have their camp right in front of the gates, but they have established outposts all over Enderal, as you have undoubtedly already noticed.
Yeah.
You are familiar with teleport magic, aren't you?
Yes.
Here, take this scroll. It will transport you directly to the Powder Desert. Oh. I need to get back to my studies now. The more we learn about the beacon, the more fascinating it becomes.
What? So it's the Powder Desert, not Duneville?
Hello.
How's the reconstruction of the beacon coming along?
Well, you heard the Grand Master. It is ready to be lit. All that's left to do is find that Numinos in order to have something we can use the stone's energy on.
Okay. So that's all we have to do is get the Numinos.
What? Okay.
I'm talking to him.
Wherever you look.
Rude boy. According to Arch-Magister Mariel, a starling called Kermai recently burgled in a storage of Ark's guardhouse, his motive to get Shadow Steel for his airship, which he wants to use to find the lost homeland of the starlings. For some reason, the old starling blueprints which Kermai uses to build his airship resemble those of the beacon. Does that mean that the ancient starlings also built the beacon? Even if not, it seems as if they knew about the cycle. Mariel wants me to help Kermai with finishing the airship. Oh. A drop in the ocean. In the course of a briefing concerning my next mission with Mariel, Yuslan asked me to visit him in his laboratory when I have time. In the Chronicum, which we're standing in, we might as well just talk to him now.
Where is this supposed to lead?
Just take a look. Oh, it goes here. Okay, that's not far from the, that's not too far from Duneville. I was afraid it was going to be in the middle of all this crap. Travel to the starship's manufactory. So, and he gave us a scroll to Duneville? He said Powder Desert. No, it's to Duneville. Alright. I thought it was gonna go to somewhere else in the Powder Desert, like a special scroll. No, it's just another Duneville scroll. I can take a Myrid there.
Is this supposed to
or I might as well use the scroll. Now, what does Yuslan want? Let's make sure this is the Chronicum, yeah.
Why can't it ever be easy?
He's down? Wait. Is he?
Come on.
Oh, I don't have it selected. I think he said up in his laboratory.
Prophetess.
Hello. How yes. Fare thee?
Yes, that just might work.
Yes, yes, see, it might work. Hello?
There you are.
Here I am.
The Shari brought that map from some Piraean ruin a couple of weeks ago.
Right.
Looks confusing, doesn't it? She said it contains more knowledge about the Piraeans than all the tomes in the Sun Temple's library put together.
Piraeans.
And now she's gone. Just like Constantine. Still feels surreal.
Yeah, we've lost some people. Is there something on your mind?
Well, let us say that I have been thinking a lot about the decisions we make in life and where they lead us.
Right.
But let's not talk about that now.
Oh, okay. Then, well, what did you want to see me about?
I did, yes, because I require your help in a personal matter.
Personal matter? Is this a good time?
There hasn't been a good time since the Red Madness broke out. And believe me, I wouldn't bother you with this if it weren't important.
Okay, what do you need?
Hard to explain. Come.
Where?
Fair enough. Where do I start? Imagine the following scenario. You're in an old fortress. Suddenly a door opens and a bandit charges in.
Right.
Before you even realize what is happening, he raises his bow, knocks an arrow, and fires it straight at your throat. What happens next?
I get hurt, or... I dodge the arrow?
That is one possibility, yes. It might be the one you would experience. Truth, however, is a bit more complex than that. Reality branches off into millions of new realities.
Right, the eventualities.
One in which the bandit kills you. One in which he gets hit by a falling piece of rubble from the ceiling.
I like that one.
One in which a tunnel spider jumps out from the shadows and kills him.
Well, that's a good one too.
The possibilities are endless.
Right.
Everything that can happen will happen. And creates a new eventuality in the process. Another reality.
Okay. So, in other words, even if I survive the arrow in one reality, I die in another?
In a million others, yes.
Boy.
There might even be one where a magical anomaly suddenly transforms the bandit into a mirad.
Huh?
Everything that can happen will happen. This is the nature of our universe.
Right. So, yeah, they're talking about the Sea of Eventualities. And am I right to assume that your request has something to do with it?
I'm getting there. I assume you know that this mechanism is also the reason for the existence of magic. An arcanist is able to transport eventualities from one reality into another, and thus perform feats considered supernatural. So far, so good.
Right.
But what if there were a way to not only bring elements of other eventualities into ours, but to travel these other realities physically?
That'd be cool. As long as you don't travel to a bad one. So you're talking about stepping into a parallel world?
I am indeed.
How is this possible?
Well, this is where it gets exciting, isn't it? With the Planeswalker. Come, let us sit.
The Planeswalker? Where are we? Are we in the bathhouse? Oh, Sentinel Quarters. Alright, stand by, guys. Okay, so now you want to sit over here and talk.
Take a seat.
Oh, I have to sit. Right.
Have you ever heard of the name Dalmaric?
Yes. The Keeper who destroyed Thalgard with the Sunfire, right. You can read about him in the Myths and Legends book for the Steel Warden.
That's the one. What hardly anyone knows, however, is that Dalmaric's experiments reached far beyond the Sunwheel. Among other things, he worked on a device called the Planeswalker, a combination of Andralian mentalism and Paraean technology.
Hmm. And this device allows its user to change realities?
Temporarily, yes. Sadly, Dalmaric never had the chance to finish it, since he was too busy blowing up Thalgard.
Oh, yeah, well, you know, priorities. So you're planning to rebuild the Planeswalker, aren't you? Why? Oh, to save Lashari? Is that even a thing? Then we could go save Constantine, too, but then we'd have to find some reality, some eventuality in which they both survive. How could we even... see that, right?
Lashari. No. Even if we were to find a reality where she didn't die, we couldn't bring her back.
Why not?
Suffice it to say that there is something I need to see.
Okay.
Something I want to see. To be honest, it wasn't my intention to drag someone else into this. But there's no other choice, so here we are.
Could such a device help us in our battle against a cycle?
It could, but not that much.
Not that much.
Other than what I'm planning to use the Planeswalker for, we lack a concrete plan for using it against the cycle.
Oh.
The only thing we could do with it is use it to blindly glimpse into other realities and hope that we can gain information in the few moments we have there.
Oh, really?
And for reasons I will elaborate on later, traveling into other realities is quite dangerous. In other words, it's not worth the risk.
Oh, okay.
No, Prophetess. Our fight against the High Ones is one we'll have to fight in this world. There's no way around that.
I wonder if there's a reality in which the High Ones don't exist. an eventuality in which they were defeated or don't exist. Should we concentrate all our resources, though, on the search for the Numenos right now?
We should, yes. But let me reassure you that this endeavor won't take up too much of our time.
Okay.
And as I've already said, I would not bother you with this if it weren't important.
So you need my help to rebuild the Planeswalker.
Indeed. It would mean a lot to me, if that's worth anything to you.
Now I'll help you out. Where do we start?
Well, first of all, we need to acquire two materials I wasn't able to find here in Ark. The Aether Crystal and a special kind of alloy. According to my research, Dalmaric's old laboratory in Thalgard would be a good place to start our search.
I just went there. What's an Aether Crystal?
Yes, I'll tell you more about it later.
Huh. Why me, though? Couldn't your Naramis allies help you out with this, too?
You mean Jaqeel and Mjörl? Yes, they could.
Who are they?
But their magical talents aren't anywhere near powerful enough to help with the activation ritual. Also, son knows why. I can't help but feel a certain amount of trust towards you.
Oh, thanks. So where is this laboratory? Somewhere in Thalgard?
Right in the middle of Thalgard's contaminated areas. So it will be dangerous. You have a map, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Here. That's where we should find the entrance. I have some preparations to make first, so let us meet there shortly. Ah, and one more thing. I would appreciate it if we could keep this matter between you and I for now. I know I've said it before, but this mission is personal, and I'd rather not have to justify it to Orenthio.
No problem.
Firstly, because it's a personal matter. Secondly, it's too much of a risk as long as Kalim and his helper are still sauntering about. The less people know of this mission, the better.
Yeah, no problem. You mentioned an activation ritual. What is that exactly?
Oh, that's complicated. We'll talk about it once we get there.
Really? Listen, if I'm to risk my life for this, I want to know what it's about. At least the essentials.
The essentials. Well, suffice it to say that what happened to Lashari and Constantine have made me question certain things. I know that they gave their lives for the greater good, but frankly, there have been times when I've found it hard to stay true to our cause. I am hoping that what I'll find over there will help me regain some sense of purpose. Yes, I know, probably not the answer you were hoping for. But it's the best I can do for now. Forgive me.
I asked for the essentials. You just told me a little about your motive. All right, let's get started then.
We will. I will meet you in Thalgard.
Luckily, I was just there, so these creatures might still be cleared out of the place, more or less. Yuslan and I had a private conversation in the Sun Temple. He had a discussion with me about the Sea of Eventualities and told me about a way to travel to different realities. For that, one needs the Planeswalker, an artifact which the Keeper Dalmaric researched many years ago. Yuslan didn't tell me why exactly he needs the Planeswalker, but I nonetheless agreed to help him with finding it. Perhaps this artifact can help us in our battle against the High Ones? First of all, we have to retrieve all necessary materials from Dalmaric's laboratory in Thalgard. Right. You won't speak. All right. We ended up back over here. So what's the fastest way over there? The golden forest, Oh, is that the destroyed abbey? Yuslan Dalmaric's old abbey in Thalgard. Yeah, that was. I explored that place, and it was one little room we couldn't get past. So I'm guessing that's what that room is has this ether shard. Is that what he said? It doesn't even say right now. I think it was called an ether shard. So yeah, we'll take the Myra Tower to the Well Watch. Myra Tower Well Watch. And then we just kind of head this way. So it's in... it might be a different abbey. I guess we'll find out. So I don't have a scroll for the Well Watch. So we'll just be heading there. My ghost key isn't working. Did he get unsummoned? He did. He has the axe of the blind miner. That's awesome. Anyway, yeah, I'll be... Yeah, then going to the Well Watch. Yeah, that'll be next episode. Longer episode, but hey, you got a lot of talking to get through. Stuff. People want to talk to me. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.